Welcome to my channel, I'm Danny Walker. Today's episode is all about how to take your own pageant headshot. If you're new to my channel, please subscribe. Also hit that notifications bell so you don't miss any new episodes. And of course, follow me on social media at Danny Walker. I am a former Miss Montana USA, and I also currently work as a pageant coach as well as a pageant judge. So I'm gonna share with you lots of behind the scenes information and tips that you can use to do your best at your next pageant. Tip number one for taking your own pageant headshot. Don't. Just don't. That's it. And we're done. Just kidding. But in all seriousness, whenever I'm working with a client, I always encourage them to get professional headshots with phenomenal hair, makeup, and wardrobe. This is something that is very, very important because oftentimes this is going to be your first impression for judges. It's important that your headshots are going to look age appropriate. So dependent on your age division or your pageant system, that you have the right amount of hair and makeup and styling for it. And also you want to make sure that your photo looks like you, because if your photo is so gorgeous and so phenomenal and it's stunning, but it doesn't look anything like you, then a lot of times judges, they tend to get really disappointed when they meet a contestant in person and she doesn't look anything like her photo. Then on the other hand, if a contestant has a really bad image and then she walks in and she's stunning, the judges are really confused and they're wondering why she wasn't as prepared as other contestants are. So you want to be right in the middle where you look like your photo, but also it has the appropriate amount of hair and makeup, like I said, for your age division and for your pageant system. Do me a favor, if you are watching on a mobile device, please screenshot this episode, post it to an Instagram story, and tag me at Danny Walker to let me know what you thought about this episode. If you absolutely have to shoot your own headshot for a pageant, here are the tips that I'm going to give you that you should think about prior to doing this. Even if you are going to be shooting your own pageant headshot, it's going to be important that you have great hair and makeup. I talked a lot about hair and makeup in another episode, and I'm going to link it up here. This is something else that you should really look into and actually pause this episode, watch that one, come back to this one, because there's lots of great information in there. Even if you cannot hire a hair and makeup artist, I strongly encourage all of my clients to get a professional hair and makeup lesson with someone who is familiar with their pageant system and with their age division. Those two things are keys when you're selecting who you're going to be working with, so that this way you'll actually be able to create a really good hair and makeup look for your own photos. If not, obviously hiring somebody else to do your hair and makeup might be a better option, even if you don't have a professional photographer to shoot with. Worst case scenario, if you can't get anyone to do your hair and makeup and you can't get a hair and makeup lesson, then at least check out some YouTube tutorials to help you practice prior to shooting your images. And that brings me to my next point. Make sure that you do a little bit of research for your own pageant system. Start looking up headshots that you've seen other title holders or contestants in your system and age division use, so you can get a general idea of what's going to be appropriate. If you love this channel and the information that I share, which I create completely in my own free time, then please do me a huge favor. If you want to continue to see episodes like this and support the channel, it's literally as easy as just sharing an episode with your friends. It helps me to help so many other young women out there who are searching for this information, and it's really the best way for you to support this channel. So please, 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 please share and uplike this video. It would really help me out a lot. Now, this is something we really need to talk about. This may sound shocking to some of you, but this is something that I have seen quite a few times, and oh my gosh, I am so embarrassed to say that I am guilty of this now that I'm thinking about it. Wow. Okay. So before selfies were a thing, I definitely took a selfie in my mom's van and submitted that as a headshot for NAMM back when I was a junior dean. Yeah. Times were tough, friends. Times were tough. Don't do that. A school yearbook photo would be better than doing that. Look at me. Put your phone down, unless you're watching this on your phone. Just pay attention. Please promise me you are not going to ever submit a selfie or a selfie photo of you with a Snapchat filter for your pageant headshot. I need a confirmation of this. Do me a favor, comment promise down below, because I need to know that you are not going to do that, because it's never a good option, ever. It's never acceptable. Don't do what I did. I can't believe I actually did that. That's totally embarrassing. Wow. That's horrific. I can't believe I did that.
Don't you do it though. Since we're not going to be taking any selfies, what can you do? Either use a self timer, which a lot of phones or cameras have, or preferably have a friend or family member take a photo for you. If you want some basic tips for how to shoot some decent images the way that I shoot a lot of my Instagram photos, then check out this video right up here for some tips before you start shooting your own pageant headshot. If you're watching this video, it's probably because you were looking to cut costs or you are entering a pageant last minute, which is something I wouldn't suggest. I like to work with my coaching clients minimum of 3 months prior to a pageant. I would love if I could get 6 months with every contestant. Doesn't always happen, but that's okay. If you unfortunately find yourself in a situation where you have basically no time to prepare for a pageant, then click the description below. You're going to find a link to my pageant crash course, which is absolutely free, and I walk you through the steps that I took to prepare for a pageant and win it within 2 weeks. Now that you have an idea of what you're going to be doing for your hair and your makeup, and you have a friend that's going to take your photo for you, let's talk about a couple other things. If you do not have access to a professional camera, don't worry about that. Smartphones are honestly a really great option, but if you're going to take one with a smartphone, make sure that you're doing it with the back camera, not the front-facing camera. The back camera right here typically has a higher resolution than the front selfie camera on your phone, which is another reason we shouldn't be taking selfies. It is preferable for you to take your pageant headshot on a plain background, just a solid colored background. You don't need anything busy or distracting back there. Now, if you end up taking your pageant headshot in portrait mode, because honestly, a lot of smartphones are really well equipped and have great cameras. So if your headshot is shot in portrait mode, you don't have to worry so much about what's going on in the background. I would just avoid really busy colors back there that would be distracting from you, because that is where the attention should be. Once you have your plain background, make sure that you are wearing bright, solid colored clothing. This tends to look best. Keep the jewelry very minimal. Typically, I would only suggest a pair of earrings. Something small like this is pretty common for most pageant headshots, a stud, sometimes a hoop. Typically, you're not gonna see contestants wearing massive rhinestone earrings, and then some contestants choose to not wear any earrings at all, and that is more than acceptable as well. After you have your hair, your makeup, your plain background, your bright, solid colored clothing, you have minimal accessories. Some things to avoid are using any props in your photo. I've seen some contestants do stuff like put flowers or things in their hair or have their hands all over their face in a photo. Those things also can be really distracting, so try to avoid all of that. Then after you have your image, if you feel like you need to edit it just a little bit, that's fine, but please don't go editing crazy. I understand airbrushing out a few blemishes that you won't have during pageant weekend or adjusting the lighting a little bit, stuff like that that's pretty minimal, but don't go crazy to the point where it looks like you got some plastic surgery in your photo. Remember, it's gonna be so important for you to show up as your authentic self, and your photo or your pageant headshot is gonna help you to do that. Those are my top tips for taking your own pageant headshot. As I said at the beginning, this is not something that I would suggest doing. Pageant headshots can honestly be a make or break thing. The year that I was first runner up as Miss Montana USA, the judges after the pageant complained about my headshot. They said that it just didn't look enough like me when I walked into the interview room, which granted your hair and makeup in interview is gonna be different than a full glam headshot, but some judges are real sticklers on that. Just something to be really aware of. I hope that you enjoyed this episode and learned something new. Be sure to check out my pageant crash course. It is linked in the description below. Subscribe, hit that notifications bell, and follow me on social media at Danny Walker. As always, if you have any video requests, leave those in the comment section below. Thank you for watching this episode, and I can't wait to see you all at the next.